you can watch the following video clips where he talks about planetary energy and shifting the planet, as well as sharing the interview stage with another New Ager that talks about collective consciousness and all of us unifying into one body. This is all New Age deception. So we can see that Mickey Willis and Dr. Rashid Buttar are both in the same camp of the New Age to deceive the masses in this film. Take a look.
That may be happening on Sunday. And the details are not important. The only thing that is important is that the energy that the planet experiences over the next 24 to 48 hours is as powerful as it can be. And we have the ability to shift, literally shift the planet. And after I'm done with my spiel here, then Dr. Lipton's gonna show us exactly how to shift the planet. So Bruce, get ready for that. But the point is,
because quantum physics is a science that recognizes that consciousness is creating our life experiences, that we, through our mind, are manifesting a reality. And there's a collective reality through collective consciousness.
And we are at that point in history right now that we must, as a global population, as a citizens of this planet, not a citizens of the United States or the UK or this country, that could, as a planetary population, recognize that, one, we are all connected. Literally, we're all connected. If you study quantum physics, you already understand that. But we are all connected, and our differences have been accentuated over the decades and over hundreds of years. Our religion, our creed, our ethnicity, our color of our skin. The point is that we need to have, as Nia said, hold that love and that gratitude and that compassion in our hearts. And starting at 11 p.m. or a.m., wherever you are, the first time the clock hits 11, I want you to then, we want you to collectively hold the intention of love and gratitude for the rest of humanity, for our planet, for the new evolutionary process that we are going towards that is part and parcel of where we are right now on this planet. And it's a difficult time, I understand, but remember that difficult, painful, chaotic time is what leads to that evolutionary process, which is necessary for growth, and that's where we're going. So hold that intention and visualization of where we are going to be in another month, 2 months, 3 months, and then when that clock hits 11 again, 12 hours later, do the same thing again, so that every hour there are millions of people that are setting that intention, holding that intention, and it cascades every hour and takes us from Saturday night till Sunday, wherever you are in the world. Just start at 11. In fact, just do it for 48 hours. Do it 3-4 times. 11, 11, 11, 11. So that's what my intention is. That's what Nia's intention is. And that's what Dr. Lipton's intention is. 3-4 times. 11, 11, 11, 11. 3-4 times. 11, 11, 11, 11.
So let's read a little bit here about 11, 11. One of the foremost 1111 experts is Solara, who heads the site invisible.com, which is devoted to the 1111 phenomenon. On it, she states, let's go down here a little bit. You have been chosen because you are ready to step into a greater reality, to lead the way for others into a new way of living, into a greater love, to ascend from duality into oneness. Would you look at that? There's a lot more, but that's that little snippet should be enough for you to get the gist of it here. And here's a quote-unquote activation ritual from this group led by this person called Solara, this woman. You get the creepy, you know, right out of creepy vibes right out of the movie Midsommar, the witch pagan cult movie that recently came out the past year or so. So very, very interesting. Continuing on, those who feel called by 1111 are instructed to channel spiritual forces through meditation, divination, sacred dance, and yoga. All these activities, according to the 1111 movement, serve to open up chakra energy points in the body and release the divine connection within. These activities are forbidden strictly by the Bible, as they lead to interaction and meddling with evil demonic forces. But for those in the New Age and movements such as 111111, the beings they are communicating with are presenting themselves as teachers and holders of ancient wisdom who will help humanity evolve into gods. I'm sure that sounds familiar to many of you. The 11-11-11 movement is a virtual smorgasbord of New Age philosophies, doctrines, and beliefs. And this also makes it more seductive as it provides avenues for many to come and be part of. The central theme is that returning to the ancient mystery religions and lost ancient knowledge will serve as a tool to unlock the divinity that is within each human being. And where did this lost knowledge originate? The workshop says it itself, the serpent in the Garden of Eden. The serpent, Satan, deceived Eve into thinking that by partaking of the fruit of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, that she could be a god. And this lie has been the foundation of satanic deception in the 6,000 plus years of human history ever since. The various New Age paths and mystery religions all tout the same goal of achieving godhood or unlocking, quote unquote, the divinity that is dormant in all of us. The idea is so attractive, not just for the boost to one's pride it gives, but it also removes the true God from the equation. And thus, any idea of sin or judgment goes as well, of course. After all, if you are God or a God, who is going to judge you? No one. Here's an interesting event surrounding the 11-11 phenomenon that took place years ago, called One Breath, One World. Okay, another major 11-11 event is the One World, One Breath. This group encourages its followers and those interested to participate in a simultaneous breathing exercise called the Aiki, or the Nine Breath Technique. Okay. So we go on here. As continues to be the case with 11-11 movements, there is the offer of the connection with the divine. Okay. Many of the followers believe they have an intense spiritual experience. One World, One Breath. Another key component of One World, One Breath is the idea of global unity. The focus of the breathing is to encompass what they call all is one. Quote, live music and breath instruction guides this conscious audience through the ultimate all is one experience. It's easy to say we are all one, but it's another thing to experience the oneness through your physical body. The effects are life-changing. Okay, here's the logo and artwork they used for their event. Of course, we can't go much further into this topic without mentioning two critical components of the New Age movement, Blavatsky, Bailey. From a spiritual standpoint, this is achieved by what Bailey called the Great Invocation, using occult meditation to contact the ascended spiritual masters and help influence society and promote the mystery religions. As Bailey stated, the new world religion of which humanity as a whole can aid the will of the planetary logos. Emphasis should be laid on the evolution of humanity. Okay, the evolution of humanity into some greater godlike being is precisely what this 11-11 phenomenon is based upon. The influence of Blavatsky and Bailey in the modern New Age movement cannot be understated. And at the root of their beliefs was a reverence for Satan. Blavatsky wrote, "One of the most hidden secrets involves the so-called fall of angels. Satan and his rebellious host will thus prove to have become the direct saviors and creators of divine man. Thus, Satan, once he ceases to be viewed in the superstitious spirit of the church, grows into a grandiose image. It is Satan who is the god of our planet and the only god. Satan, Lucifer, represents the centrifugal energy of the universe, this ever-living symbol of self-sacrifice for the intellectual independence of humanity. Secret doctrine." Okay, Alice Bailey, who named her company in honor of Lucifer, and Blavatsky both preached the message of evolution of humanity, spiritual oneness and harmony. But at the end of the day, they are instructing their readers and adherents to not only view Satan as good, but as the savior and creator, thus twisting the biblical account of the devil and making him the god to be worshipped. Okay, this is what it's all about, guys, right here. Which is exactly what the Bible predicted would take place as the world is prepared for the Antichrist. We see here why 11-11 is going to be the most magical day of 2019, according to witches. Amazing. We know that 11 also signifies, of course, the twin pillars of Freemasonry. This is why they chose the towers. The towers represent the twin pillars, Jachin and Boaz. 11, the master number. Okay, the big Freemason signature here. This is what it represents. Of course, Bush, his infamous New World Order speech, taking place exactly 11 years before 9/11, on 9/11/1990, right? We have the High Priestess, 11 twin pillars.
It's my dad's favorite number, born 111. Kyrie Irving is 11 letters. Played 11 games at Duke. I was drafted in 2011. I scored my 11,000 point on the 11th. You know, 11 is a path of mastery. It's a master number. I have my preheat coming out on 11-11, which is also Singles Day. 11 different cities, 11 different aesthetics. It's just a unique purpose that I want to fulfill.
As a citizens of this planet, not as citizens of the United States or the UK or this country, that country, as a planetary population, recognize that one, we are all connected.
The fool hath said in his heart, there is no God. They are corrupt. They have done abominable works. There is none that doeth good.